desmoid tumor is a benign, locally aggressive tumor which arises from the deep soft tissue. It's a very rare disease. And currently and historically, it was treated like a sarcoma. But right now, the medical community started to understand more and more how this tumor behaves. And now we have new guidelines and new way of treating those tumors. Currently, the desmoid tumors which are treated by interventional radiology are desmoid tumors in the chest wall, abdominal wall, or the limbs, so upper or lower limbs. We do not treat intra-abdominal tumors, obviously, because there are a lot of safety concerns regarding those tumors in that specific location. There are different ways to treat desmoid tumors. Currently, the first approach should be watch and wait, active surveillance. You are simply monitoring the tumor with imaging, looking at the potential growth of those lesions. Because we know from the experience that up to 1/3 of those tumors will stay stable and 1/3 of those tumors may spontaneously shrink with time. Other options include systemic treatments, mostly non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, anti-hormonal therapies, and new treatments also include tyrosine kinase inhibitors, and for very aggressive disease, chemotherapy. For local treatments, there are different options, non-IR treatments, so surgery and radiation therapy, and for a couple of years now, interventional treatments and mostly percutaneous cryoablation. There are specific challenges when you come to treat desmoid tumors. Usually those tumors that will be referred to you will be very big tumors, up to 10, 15 centimeters. So you can imagine the challenge for a percutaneous treatment. Another issue with those treatments is the usual proximity of nerves and other vulnerable structures such as bone, joints, or bowel, for example, if you are treating the treating tumors in the abdominal wall. There are different options to avoid complication. The first one is to properly select the patient and do not go for all tumors to be treated because you may face very bad complications. You need to be able to protect the skin, to protect the nerves using dissection, maybe hydro or cryodissection. Also use of neurostimulation to make sure that there is no damage to the nerve during the treatment. Use of carbodissection to push the bowel away, and use of temperature monitoring to check the local temperature close to the nerve throughout the ablation process. Those are different modalities that have to be used in most of the cases when you are going to treat desmoid tumors. There is currently only scarce literature available regarding the use of interventional radiology to manage desmoid tumors. Most of the publications, but you can count it on the finger of your hand, are based on cryoablation. So there are, I think, 3 to 4 retrospective single center studies and 1 prospective multicentric studies, which was performed in France. The limitation currently is the relatively short follow-up. So of course we need longer follow-up to make sure that our treatments are effective on a long-term basis. But all in all, those publications support the use of cryoablation as a very effective alternative to surgery as a first-line treatment for desmoid tumors. One very interesting topic that has to be studied still is tumor selection. What we do not know right now exactly is what kind of desmoid tumor will mostly and best respond to percutaneous procedures. So there's a huge work to be done in that field. Also, we need studies with a longer follow-up. When I mean longer, I would say 5 to 10 years follow-up, making sure that the initial treatment that looks promising is actually promising on a long-term basis. In the very next future, let's say 5 years from now, I really believe that interventional radiology will be the first-line treatment option for local management of desmoid tumor. And also, I think that what will change is the type of tumors that we are going to treat. So hopefully, we'll move from desperate cases tumors measuring 10 centimeters, almost impossible to treat completely, to smaller tumors. And for that optimal tumor selection, we need to understand better the disease. That will be the game changer for the management of desmoid tumors using interventional radiology.